أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وأصحابه وبارك وسلم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. We first thank and praise the Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala which is the cause of our very existence. And we are grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for creating the heavens and the earth. وَسَخْرَ لَكُمْ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ. Created in such a way, acknowledging and carrying out the orders of Allah, and in the same time, subservient to humankind. And we, as the human being, we enjoy the tayyibah, the goodness of this dunya. Grateful we are to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for granting humankind anbiya from the beginning of time, from Adam alayhi salatu wa salam right up to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to guide and to admonish and to show humankind what it is to practice the mustaqima, indeed the highway to the akhirah. Grateful we are to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, wa ma arsalnaka illa rahmatan lil alameen, for granting the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as a rahmah to the alameen. And we know, as the human being, a creation of Allah, and we form part of the alameen that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created the human being on the highest form. وَلَقَدْ كَرَّمْنَا بَنِي آدَمَ. Created in such a way that we can utilize the very intelligence that Allah has given us. We can accept and we can reject, and we can distinguish between virtue and sin. And that makes us the vicegerent or the Khalifa that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created. And when we study humankind, you will find Jamaat al-Muslimin, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent guidance through the passages of time to remind humankind that they came onto this dunya and inevitably they are going to leave the dunya. And therefore, this life that Allah has given us indeed is the most valuable asset, and we are going to be answerable for this life Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has granted to each and every human being. And so the prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala came to show humankind how to practice the mustaqimah. And we know that Allah has seen Nabi Dawood with the Zabur. Allah has seen Nabi Isa with the Injil. Nabi Musa with the Torah. And finally, Allah has sent Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with the guidance of the Holy Quran. And we find Jamaat al-Muslimin, the Quran is Kalamullah. It is not man-made. It did not come from a human being, but divinely revealed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And for us as the human being, especially those who have made the amana, we have made an oath with Allah that we are going to comply with the tenets of Islam. And therefore, it becomes incumbent for each and every Muslim to study the biography of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and to study the Quran. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not just to grant us knowledge, but to grant us to understand the ayats of the Holy Quran. Although we will never be able to give the analyzation of the ayats, and because as sometimes we hear the word tafsir, the Quran tafsir itself, meaning to the passages of time, things are becoming clear. Ayats that we thought we knew 20 years ago is standing up today because we have also developed as a human being. And therefore, the Quran came in a time when humankind was ready, right, to utilize that very intelligence, and to study the Tawheed of Allah, the existence of Allah. And that is, that makes us a Muslim. Because it's no use we believe in the oneness of Allah, but we cannot explain the existence of Allah. And we say the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam is Khatam al-Nabiyyin, but we cannot defend the life of the Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And therefore, the most important thing in the life of a Muslim is the Shahada. Because that is the oath that we have made. That is the oath that we have said to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we are going to adhere and abide with those laws that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prescribed. But we know as a human being, we err, we fall, we crawl, and sometimes we forget, and sometimes we're neglectful. And the Quran is there to guide us. It's a bitter medicine at times, but it is the guidance that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent to this earth, and not just for the Muslim, but for each and every human being, to gain from the guidance that is so powerful that will stand the test of time. And today, Jamaatul Muslimin, each and everyone, we look at ourselves, and as we know by now, how sacred life is. And because this is the life that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has granted. Allah is the creator of the ruh. No one can explain the ruh. A secret by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so when we study the Quran of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we will find Jamaatul Muslimin. There's guidance for us, especially when it comes to the human being, this very life that we are to be found in. And at times, how we think that we, at times, we are so involved in the ghurur of the dunya, then we forget there's going to come a time when we have to leave this dunya. But how are me and you going to leave this dunya? But what? And so, Jamaatul Muslimin, each and everyone is going to be answerable for each minute, for each hour, for each day that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has granted to me and to you. And so the life that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has granted us is indeed what we can say. It is borrowed time. It is not our time. And we need to utilize the time Allah has given us to the best of our ability. And so we use the Quran to bring to our mind verily how Allah has guided humankind 1442 years ago. And how the Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam had to give the spark of knowledge. And any person who searches for knowledge, he acknowledges Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because Allah is the creator of each and every living biological organism that has to be found on the earth. And so we take Surah Ghafir, ayat number 67, and see what we can derive. And how Allah guides us, and how at times we recite the Quran, but sometimes we do not know what we are reciting. And therefore it becomes incumbent for each and every Muslim to learn, to study, to explore. And because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us that ability, that we can, which we can say, develop through time, that we are able then, right? If we are confronted with any, which we can say, this pandemic or with any calamity, we will be able to survive and come out of it. Because a Muslim should never give up. A Muslim should never give up hope. But it also needs to be put to action. And so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brings to us, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. وَالَّذِي خَلَقَكُم مِّن تُرَابٍ. And there, Jamaatul Muslimin, Allah brings to us that Allah has created, وَالَّذِي خَلَقَكُم مِّن تُرَابٍ, humankind from the turab, meaning from the elements of the earth. And so we came from the earth. and we're going to live from the earth. And when we die, to just put us back to the earth. So nothing goes to waste. And here we will find Jamaat Muslimin. When we take this ayat and we join it with another ayat where Allah says, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, inni ja'ilun fil ardi khalifa. Allah has created a vizier and a khalifa on the ard. And so Jamaat Muslimin, too many stories that humankind were created in the Jannah. And then a sin was committed, and then we were put out of the Jannah, Adam and Hawa. Now, Jamaat Muslimin, we utilize the Quran of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَالَّذِي خَلَقَكُمْ مِنْ تُرَابٍ ثُمَّ مِنْ نُطَفَةٍ. And here Allah brings to us. Allah has created the male with the nutafa, with the sperm. Right? So this ayat is to do with the phases of our life and how we came onto this dunya. And at the ultimate end, Allah brings to us. Sometimes that we think we're going to live till 70 or 80. When we take maybe our mother or our father have lived to 80 or whatever, then we sometimes think we're going to reach that age. But this is the ayah that will open our faculty of reasoning, that the time that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us is valuable. وَالَّذِي خَلَقَكُمْ مِنْ تُرَابٍ ثُمَّ مِنْ نُطَفَةٍ ثُمَّ مِنْ عَلَقَةٍ. And then Allah brings to us the embryonic stages of life. How that nutafa will fuse with the ovum. And how it fused with the ovum of our mother. And how one cell became trillions of cells. A mu'jiza that no one can explain. The Quran, 442 years ago, brings to us, if you study as a gynecologist or physician and you take the Quran, you will say to yourself, this will convince me and you that the Quran is Kalamullah. And ya Allah brings to us min nutafa, min alaqa. And so we will then, as you can say, started off in the womb of our mother. We attached to the umbilical cord onto the placenta. And who was there? For that there is survival in the womb of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How did we get the oxygen, the sustenance to survive? We needed oxygen to survive. And so we submitted already in the womb. It's the start of our iman. When we submitted to the oxygen, then we submitted the one who's the cause of the oxygen. So how can a person still say, he does not believe there is Allah? That person, you say to him to close his mouth and his nose and see if he can survive. You won't be able to survive because we were created from the elements of the earth and we are going to use the sustenance of the earth and we are going to use what Allah has created to put forth our lives, and we need that oxygen. And the moment you submit to the oxygen, you submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without you knowing. And that is Jamaat al-Muslimin. Allah brings to us, وَالَّذِي خَلَقَكُمْ مِنْ تُرَابٍ ثُمَّ مِنْ نُطَفَةٍ ثُمَّ مِنْ عَلَقَةٍ ثُمَّ يُغْرِزُكُمْ تِفْلًا ثُمَّ لِتَبُلُغُوا أَشَدُّكُمْ. And ya Allah brings to us, and how we developed for 9 months in the womb, and how we were born as a baby. And what do we say? Alhamdulillah. Look at the eyes. Look at the nose. But we do not realize, Jamaat Muslimin, what has transpired in the womb. We cannot even see the nutafa with the naked eye. It needs to be magnified 1,000 times for me and for you to see it. Like the head of a needle pin, bringing to us. But it contains your whole genetic makeup to be found in that cell that we cannot even see with the naked eye. Imagine, Jamaat Muslimin, how everything develops from that and how it fuses. Isn't that to bring us nearer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Isn't that to bring us to appreciate how we came onto this dunya and who brought us onto this dunya with the qudra of Allah? And Allah brings to us, ثُمَّ لِتَبْلَغُوا أَشَدُّكُمْ ثم لن تكونوا شيوخا. And then Allah made us to become strong. So we developed from a baby, and then we started to crawl, and we started to walk. And then we were longing to become a teenager. And after teenager, we were longing for our 21st. And so we were longing for our birthdays as we grow up. But this is a reminder for us, the Muslims, each and every birthday that we celebrate is nearer to our time of departure. And Ya Allah brings to us, Thummali tukunu, that Allah has made us strong. We develop to become strong. And then Allah brings to us, Suyukha wa min kum min yatawaffa. And then Allah reverses us back to old age. Wa min kum may yatawaffa. And do nothing, that we all are going to go through that stages, the stages that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala means in this ayat, the stages of babyhood, the stages of a teenager, the stages of becoming 21 and from there 50. Allah brings to us, for us, Jamaatul Muslim, do not think you're going to go through all those stages. And because Ya Allah brings us, min qablu wa litablughu ajalan musamma. Your time is already being prescribed. Isn't that bring to us the time Allah has given us? Is not our time. When we came onto this dunya, our time is already being prescribed. And how many times you say, yes, it's words. Then we say, when we wish someone a birthday wish, and we say, may Allah grant you a long umr. But we cannot ask Allah to extend your umr, your life. It's already ordained by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you came under this dunya, your time of departure is already ordained. What happens in between? It is what me and you, how we are going to carry out this life or this amana that we've accepted after we leave the ard. And because we're going to utilize the ard, because the ard will take us to the year after. And therefore, if we comply and we uphold that amana that we have accepted out of our own free will, we will see it in the year after. And therefore, no one can cut themselves off from the art. We need the art. And that brings to us, Jamaat Muslimin, قَبْلُ وَلِتَبْلُغُوا عَجَلًا مُسَمَّى وَلَعَلَّكُمْ تَعْقِلُونَ. Look at Allah brings to us again. تَعْقِلُونَ, what does it mean? In order that you may understand, in order that you may ponder, in order that you may utilize your akal. Does it come to your mind? We're not going to be here forever. And so the time Allah has given us is indeed borrowed time. How many of us have family members, babyhood, that passed on? The other day I had a young boy, a janaza of 8 years old. It's very seldom when you have a janaza of an 8-year-old or 9-year-old. Then you think to yourself, look how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prescribed. Right? This was the end. Right? No one can extend. That is the secret of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But it brings to our mind at times, Jamaat Muslimin, we think we're going to be here forever. But this ayat is a reminder for each and everyone. At times you say, no, I'm going to wait for the Ramadan. And then I'm going to try and uplift myself spiritually. You might not see Ramadan. How many of us say, oh, maybe next week? You might not see next week. And that is Jamaatul Muslimin, how sacred life is, how valuable this life is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has granted us. It's not our life. And so no man can say, I can do what I want to do. No, Jamaatul Muslimin, we have made it amana and we need to comply, because at the ultimate end, we cannot say there weren't any warnings. We cannot say there weren't any guidance. And that is the guidance that stares us in the face every day. The illustrious, the glorious Quran. And so many of us, we are fond of reciting Surah Yasin. Where Allah brings to us in Surah Yasin, وَمَنْ نُؤَمِّرُ نَكِّسُ فِي الْخَلْقِ. Again, أَفَلَا يَعْقِلُونَ. Again, use your intelligence. Ponders, try to think where Allah brings. Nunakisu, what does it mean? It means, Jamaatul Muslimin, at times we think, right? When we were 30 or 40 and you were a bricklayer, you used to lay 1,000 bricks. And now when you're 50 and going to 60, the mind still says to you, you can lay 1,000 bricks. Nakisu, meaning the body is slowly dying off. The cells are dying and the body cannot produce anymore the cells as it used to produce when you were young. And then you find yourself, you cannot do what you have been able to do, which you can say 10 or 20 years ago. Again, Allah brings to us to utilize that intelligence, that this is the life Allah has given me. And I must utilize this life according to the tenets of Islam. And beautifully, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam brings to us, Jamaatul Muslimin. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم خير الناس من طال عمره وحسن عمله وشر الناس من طال عمره وساء عمله. The best of humankind, the Prophet brings to us, are those who utilize this life that Allah has given to me and to you. It's a long life. 20 years is a long life. 30 years is a long life. And so the best of humankind are those who utilize the life Allah has given me and you to uphold that very ahkam that you've accepted, that oath that you have made. And you live with your fellow human being to be there for one another. To be there, Allah has created us dependent one on the other. Those are the best of people because He knows that the time is valuable. There's no such thing as a Muslim that you become bored. A Muslim should not become bored. There's too much things to do. Sometimes it's not the boredness, it's your ruh. Your ruh needs the medicine so that you can then practice this deen that me and you have accepted to the best of your ability. And then the Prophet ended off, wa sharru nas man talu sharru. Nas mantal, meaning, and those of Allah has given a long life, but He does everything contrary of evil, sharr, nas, everything of evil. Those are the worst of people because there is no gratitude, there is no appreciation that you show out to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And how do me and you show out our appreciation? We take our noblest part, our identity, our face, and our forehead, and we prostrate in sujood to the ground. And we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for this life that Allah has given to me and to you. And the Jamaatul Muslimin, if you find yourself today at the age, I'll use 50. If you find yourself today at the age of 50 and you did not start with a very khamsa salam, then Jamaatul Muslimin, you have almost lost the link to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have already starting to lose the link to the year after. But you all long for the Jannah. But the Jannah is going to be expensive. It's going to come at the price, at the sacrifice. And what is the sacrifice? The sacrifice indeed, Jamaatul Muslimin, for me and for you, to utilize the very akal Allah has given us so that we can know what is our purpose on the earth. Because at the ultimate end, Jamaatul Muslimin, we are going to be accountable for this life Allah has given us. Iqra kitabak. Then we must then be able, right, to produce the life that Allah has given us. And so Jamaatul Muslimin, we do not want to be of those. You see, you started off when we were young, we were in the front sarf, the masjid. And as time goes, when it kicks in, when Allah reverses us back to weakness, and we find ourselves sitting at the back on the chair. But then you can say to yourself, Alhamdulillah, when I was young, I've utilized my time, I was able to do my salah in the tartib. My ruku, my sujood, my practicalities of the salah was perfect. Today I cannot bend because of old age. And then I say, Allahu Akbar. But do not be of those who have wasted your youth. And at the end, and then you want to appeal to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But whilst you were young in your youth years, you did not care. But do not despair in the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at this point in time, this very life that Allah has given us, me and you, I speak to myself also, must utilize this life. It's so precious, it's so valuable. Must utilize it at the best of our ability and do not think and set out things for next week or next month, because we do not know even if we're going to see our homes when we leave the masjid. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant our Muslimin and Muslimat, those who live the dunya, may Allah grant them my place in the Jannah. May Allah grant those who are sick at home, wherever you are, and whatever religion you belong to. If you seek somewhere on the earth, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bring shifa. Walhamdulillah, ya Rabbil Alameen.